Hi there, it is John Miller from KuduTek.com with another Excel Navigator version 1.0.54 update video for you. Many of you have asked whether it's possible to increase the size of the vertical tab buttons, the text size as well as the item width. In this version 1.0.54, we've done just that. So now we have 29 tabs in this example, and if you go to the Excel Navigator tab here on the ribbon bar, you'll see there's new user options. Now we have slider controls that you can use to change the tab size, the tab width, and the tab height. You can also reset to the original settings, or you can click OK and the settings will save and persist. So next time when you open up Excel, the new changed vertical tabs will still be there, but you can always revert back to the original settings if you wanted to. So let's just experiment with this a little bit. Let's say you would like to see the text a little larger. You can just slide that control. As the text gets a little larger, you can see though that the buttons get a little more condensed or compacted there. So this is where the tab height might be handy to just increase the tab height a little bit. And if you want to get a little more width there, you can just slide that control as well. And that's basically how you would change the size and the text size of the vertical tab buttons. When you're done with that, you just click OK. If you have a really long tab name. So sheet 3. Maximum tab length. So that's full length. And if we just refresh the sheets, you'll see it's not really legible right now. So let's take a look and see what the original settings would have looked like with such a long tab name. First of all, so I'll just reset it to the original. So yeah, it looks a little compacted there as well, right? You can kind of see it, but it's small and it's a little cluttered there. So let's see what we can do about this. First of all, you can increase the tab width to make it fit nicely. Maybe the text is a little small, so you can make that a little larger. Now, as you make it larger, obviously the text is going to take up more space as well, so you can make it a little wider again. In this case, we're running out of width, so you can also increase the tab height. So you can experiment with this and just come up with the sizes that work for you. And if you're happy with your settings, you just click OK, and now you have really large and very legible sheet tabs. One example where this could also be handy is when you increase the size of the content of a worksheet using the slider down here below, for example. If you want to zoom in, you can make the contents larger, but notice that the sheet tabs still have the same size text. That doesn't change at all. So if you are somebody maybe with a visual impairment, then I think this could be also handy. As you increase the size of your content so that it's more legible for you, you can also do the same with the vertical tabs to supplement or replace the horizontal tabs there down below. And you know, there's also an option to hide the horizontal tabs in Excel. I'll show that in another video. I just wanted to demonstrate what's new in this latest version of Excel Navigator. So the Excel Navigator add-in for Excel makes navigation in Excel workbooks very easy. There's a lot of functionality planned to be added in future. One of the next things we want to do with the vertical tabs is to also give you the ability to set colors, customize the colors on the vertical tabs. We're also going to focus on the date picker and add some extra functionality and features there. So that's what's new in this version of Excel Navigator. If you you're a current user of the Excel Navigator add-in, an earlier version of it, you may be able to easily update to this version. If you open up the task tray or service tray, whatever they call it, and you see this little Kudu Excel Navigator icon, you can double click on it. And then you can click on the check for updates button. And if you have an earlier version, the 1.0.5 something series, you should be able to use this update feature to look for new updates and update to this latest version. So it makes it really easy. You may have to close Excel before you apply the update. If you don't see the icon there, you can still easily install the new version. And once you install the new version, you'll have the updater service available for future releases as they come out. But if you don't see that, you may have to go into your add and remove programs and then remove the old version of Excel Navigator. And then just go to KuduTek.com, go to Excel Navigator, and the links will take you from there to download a free version of Excel Navigator. Thank you very much for watching. Appreciate your support. Until next time.